How do doctors look at your MRI images to get information? In one of my prior videos, I explained how doctors use diagnostic tools to find out what's going on with you. And many of you have had studies, so-called the MRIs of your spine. I'm sure some of you bring your MRI studies home because you have your doctor's visit in the near future, but then you plugged that information into your computer and now you're looking at images like these. So let me explain. On the left-hand side of your screen is something called a cross-sectional view or axial view of the cervical spine. This is a neck MRI. On this right-hand side is the side view or sagittal views. And so you can see the spinal cord, which is this gray band that goes down the middle in this side view. And you can also see the spinal cord in the center of the canal on this axial view. So doctors like to go back and forth from one image to the next to see what's going on. So let me try to accelerate your experience of understanding what an MRI would be by doing it this way. So if we take this left-sided cross-sectional view and superimpose it onto the sagittal views like this, and take each slice like this, now you're understanding how doctors are looking at these images. If you take these images and flip them around, now you understand how we're taking the sagittal image here and superimposing it onto the axial image here. And now we have a pretty good understanding of a person's anatomy. If we go back and then superimpose the animations of what these things are representing, let's do it again. Here's the axial views being superimposed on the sagittal views at each level. And then you can kind of reconstruct this in this manner using animation to have an understanding of what these anatomies look like using both animation and actual MRI images. I hope you go back and forth on this video so you have a better understanding of how doctors look at your MRIs. There's lots of technical components to this, but this will give you some idea of how we put this information together. Thanks for watching. I hope this answers some questions for you. Please let me know if there's any questions you may have and just post it onto my website or onto my YouTube channel, and I'll be sure to select questions that are most common and make videos to answer those questions in the future. Thanks again.